right, so this week's tip is from a question that one of my followers has sent in to me. I thank you guys for sending those comments, the questions. Try to answer them in the DMs as quick as I can. I appreciate you hitting the subscribe button on YouTube if you haven't already. And Facebook Business, that's been incredible. We've gotten so many views on that, and I thank you guys for that. So we're gonna talk about gilding. And I've got Big here, who is a recently gilded guy here, just 3 years old. And I'll just tell you a little bit about him. He is by Walla Walla Wids. He's bred well, bred good. He's not, his mother's bred well. You know, maybe not as far as like earnings wise, didn't have a ton of earnings, but real pretty prospect, as you can see, built nice. And that's why we bought him as a yearling. Rode him as a 2 year old, really pretty darn good, going through the basics, no issues. And then early the 3 year old year, so earlier this year, just started noticing with this training that he'd come out on Mondays just a little on edge, you know, kind of springtime, and you could just tell he was kind of thinking about other things than the training. And so I'd end up spending, I don't know, at least half of my ride just working on his focus, which, you know, all horses, you're working on focus, but with stallions, you sometimes can run into working on that all the time. And Mother Nature can pull a lot harder than I can. So it kind of just came down to the fact, what's best for Big here? You know, I'm kind of having to, you know, he's basically like a teenager forever. I'm having to always remind him and tell him. And anyway, talked to Mary Beth Ruckman, the owner, and we got to talking about it. And I said, you know, we could leave him as a stallion and potentially he could get through this, maybe. But if we geld him, we're gonna have a really nice horse. All that good stuff you see, more of that's gonna rise to the top instead of always dealing with that testosterone, you know. Then you go start hauling him to shows. He's acting like a good old sweet gelding now. You start hauling him to horse shows, he's gonna get, you know, worked up about other horses, stalling next to other people, same thing. Or even just, you know, you're out riding with your friends and you've got to deal with a stud that's giving you problems. You know, it can be dangerous for you, but it's also way harder for this horse. So we went ahead and gelded him earlier this year, and for him, he was one of the ones that it was like night and day. It was like he threw his hands up. He's like, okay, I have nothing else to think about except what you want to do. And now he's become a really solid, consistent horse to train. And who knows how he's going to show. Hopefully he shows well. I think he's going to do well. But I can tell you one thing. Life is so much easier for him now because that 50%, you know, that fight that we'd get into over his focus, that's gone now. So now he's just absorbing the training. I don't have to ride him near as much, near as hard. Anybody can handle him. You can give him cookies now, do whatever you want. And he's totally good with it. So where I'm going with that is, when you ask, when should I geld my horse? Well, it's never too early. You know, check with your vet and see, but you know, you can geld him as early as you want. Now, myself personally, being honest, and you know, if they're really ugly, you know, and there's no bad conformation, all that good stuff, I might geld them as yearlings for sure. But typically I'm picking horses that I think are gonna be prospects down the road. So it's pretty much in their 2 year-old year. The minute they start, you know, I start thinking, all right, they know enough, but we're still having, you know, still getting into stuff, the same issue every single day. Immediately I start thinking about gelding. Again, if you keep thinking about what's best for the horse, it makes it kind of an easy decision. You go, all right, should I, you know, do you want his life to be a whole lot harder or you want it to be easier? And if you say easier, gelding's the answer. Then that brings you to the next thing. This is where we all get in trouble. We all have in our mind, we want an ex-breeding stallion. You know, we think the stud needs the testosterone to get stronger and all that. Well, in our business in the reining, we've had geldings do really well. They've won all our major events. You want to eat some grain? So that theory is no good. It doesn't matter whether they're gelding stud or mare. The other thing is the value. You start going, well, if I geld him, he's not worth anything now. Well, guess what? How many times have you seen a stud that's, you know, you're watching and the horse is fighting somebody in the arena, you know, having a hard time, maybe his conformation's not great, maybe it is, but the stud doesn't perform. What's that stud worth versus a good gelding or a great gelding? I think this is something our industry needs to change, and I challenge you guys to start being part of that change. In the reining world, we have a ton of stallions. I think we need to start changing that and start putting an emphasis on just having really good horses And, you know, I have, gosh knows, I have a lot of studs in the barn. If you have a stallion that's bred well, has the confirmation to go along with it, and you hardly even know if that horse is a stallion or not, that's probably one that you don't need to worry about. If you're having conversations about gelding him, you probably need to go ahead and do it. Long story short, my theory is I'd rather have a great gelding than an average, tough stallion every day of the week. It's that simple. As soon as they start giving me trouble, I want to geld them. Of course, I've got owners I've got to deal with that I've got to get on the same page with me. But I think if you present that, you know, you present it where, hey, you want things to be easier or harder for your horse, it makes that decision simple. You always keep that horse's interest in mind first, you're pretty much going to be right every single time.
Looking to step your game up? Perfect. All you have to do is go to mattmillsreining.com. It's only $24.95 a month, so sign up today, because the key to success is knowing.